Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania 3 Dracula's Curse. Last time, we rescued Cypher, and we're continuing today on our path to the surface. The other pathway, the one we skipped, was the underground path that would have led us to Alucard, and a completely different set of levels. I'll eventually go back and start a new save file to show Alucard's pathway off, because they ultimately converge when we get to the castle proper. But for today, we're going to try and make it the end of the surface path. So those big skeleton knights, they move like Medusa heads, a little bit. They're a little bit more erratic, but they're... Well, I guess erratic's not a word for it, because they're still very predictable. So their arc starts off pretty short, and then as they move across the screen, the arc, their vertical arc, kind of gets a little bit bigger. But as long as you know the trick to that, they're really no big deal. In fact, you can skip most of the ones, as you saw, in that room. Really don't have to fight that many of them. We'll see a couple more of them as we make our way up the tower. I think it's called, like, Hell's Tower or something. Making your way over the Spark Mandrill Sparks. And here, we're gonna get introduced to kind of the gimmick of the level. It is a little bit of an auto-scroller, in a way. So the ceiling is gonna lower at fixed intervals, and if we stay still too long, we will just fall into the floor and die. So, can't stay still too long, but you also can't rush your way up, because the enemies don't actually spawn until there's enough room on screen for them to spawn. So if you're, like, on the middle of the stairs, before they spawn in, they can just spawn on top of you and hurt you. Oh, that was stupid. Why did I do that? So then, not taking damage going through there. And then when you get around this point is when it stops scrolling, because you've reached the end of the screen. There is another auto-scroller coming up somewhere. I can't remember where, though. I don't know if it's this level or the next one. We saw these spiked floors earlier. They're a variation of a mechanic that the game taught us about way, way earlier on. And if you jump on them, they'll first rotate, and if you're standing still, you'll fall through the floor as they rotate. And then if you jump, and you're not jumping forward, you're just kind of neutral jumping, as the platform rotates, you'll land on the spikes when you finally jump, when you finally fall from the jump. So, just don't jump on them. It's kind of a way to uncomplicate the whole mess. I just kind of verbally slogged through. This is kind of a hard screen. This might be one of the hardest screens that we've encountered so far in the entire game. Okay, so I'm gonna whip those fireballs, and I can make my way up here. It's not the hardest part yet, though. It's one of the hard parts. I'm gonna have to do some cool threading the needle here. Threading of the needle. Okay. Shit, I went too early! Damn it. Okay, well, this is the hard part anyway. Because you really don't have much in the way of a pixel to, of slack. There we go. Yeah, that's a hard screen. That's pretty tough to, not take much damage on. I'm mad at myself because I took stupid damage. I took damage for moving too early. Birds. I think those birds are probably the enemies I struggle most with. A lot of people hate Medusa heads because they're too tough. Those birds kill me. Hey, wall chicken. I fucking love that. It's always chicken. You just find chicken in the walls. It's like one of the oldest things in gaming that still makes me laugh really hard sometimes. Frankenstein here is, one of the more threatening bosses we've come across so far. I very much doubt that he's going to be capable of killing me. But, yeah, he's one that can provide a little bit of damage to you, as opposed to some of the easier bosses. Bosses by now have all seemed pretty easy, and I don't disagree if you're saying, oh, the Castlevania 3 boss, why is everyone saying Dracula's Curse is so hard and bosses are so easy? I don't disagree that they're easy, but I think the philosophy behind bosses is that they're just meant to finish you off after the level itself wears you down. They expect you to be low enough on health when you reach the boss that one or two silly mistakes will get you killed on the easy bosses, and... it's much easier to make those mistakes on some of the more medium-level difficulty bosses as you get later in the game. And then, even though you respawn right before the boss with full health, when you die, you lose all your power-ups. You're weak as Whipper, your rip is weaker, there we go! You're weak as Whipper, you don't have a sub-weapon when you respawn. So, the first time you die to a boss, it's gonna get a little bit harder because you're depowered even though you respawn at full health. So if you glide through the levels pretty easily, and you manage to make it the boss the first time with full health, the boss is gonna be easy, always. But if you have a hard time with the stage, the boss just picks you off. I think that's the philosophy behind why the bosses seem so easy. No dagger for me. We got double. I think someone mentioned in the comments what they do is allow you to throw multiple, sub-weapons at once out. As opposed to waiting for the first one you throw out to leave the screen. And then a triple would do exactly what it sounds like, allow you to throw three out. Okay, these guys are a pain in the ass. They can throw their axe high or low, and you have to respond accordingly. You have to either jump low, or attack it low, or you have to attack it high, or duck it. But that's why I like holy water. Because holy water, the flame on it, hits the axe high or low. And it kind of keeps you safe. You don't really have to react that way. Oh, no stopwatch. I'd like to keep the holy water for a little while longer. So these stages that we're getting into now, these are like the midway stages, I guess. They're where the game starts to get a bit harder. Every screen becomes a lot more dangerous at this point. Hey, the wall chicken. I do love wall chicken, it's so dumb! Why is it chicken? Oh. For this and more observations from 30-year-old games, please hit that subscribe button. Oh my god, I can't believe I made it. Under the bird bite. Oh, caught up to me. That was almost incredibly clutch. Almost good. Alright, so this is the last screen before our next boss, and this is the boss I like a whole bunch. I don't even mind having the axe. The holy water's not gonna do me much good here. So these are the water serpents. They'll come from two different angles, usually, sometimes. Like that. They'll, unsubmerge from weird angles. Actually, I don't know why I jumped into that. Oop, well, that's not a decent spot to be hitting him. For the most part, though, right over. I just like to chill out and set a platform. Because there's not many configurations they can pop up in that can, actually hit you from the center platform. That one! If I hadn't killed the one on the left, they could've hit me there, because he, had me surrounded. Yeah, a little bit lucky that he was on his last legs. And then the axe is really, really nice for this fight. I like that. I enjoy that fight a lot. It's a good ass boss. One of the best in the game, I think. That one, Death and Dracula, I think are probably my three favorites. This song is called Aquarius, and the beginning of it reminds me a lot of Bloody Tears, which first showed up in Simon's Quest. And that is one of the only redeeming factors of Simon's Quest, is that it introduced the song Bloody Tears, which is the best song in all of Castlevania. This stage has awesome stage music. And a lot of tricky platforming. The enemies in this one aren't too bad. There's one screen, which I think might be the one above me right now, which is a huge pain in the ass to not get hit on. And I don't know how I'm gonna accomplish that with holy water. Like that. Yeah. Damn it. Like, a couple frames too soon. Yeah, that one's hard. It would probably be made easier by having the axe, but yeah. Yeah, it's a fun little tip. You can actually hit enemies above you with holy water on the floor above you by throwing it at the ceiling. And fire will spread through the ceiling into the floor above you. These aren't too bad. I feel like they tinkered with the timing on these dragon towers, I think they're called, from Castlevania 1. I think they tinkered with the timing of the fireball, so that it's a little bit easier to just whip the fireballs and destroy them that way. It felt a lot harder to do in Castlevania 1. Felt like you couldn't just spam. Maybe they increased the speed of the whip slightly. Maybe that's it. But either way, it feels like in Castlevania 1, you had actually time when you hit the button to whip, whereas in Dracula's Curse, you can kind of just spam it to destroy those fireballs. Or you can just jump them, but I feel like that's inherently more risky than just spamming the whip and destroying them. Yeah, this is the part of the song that makes me think of Bloody Tears. This is such a good track. Okay, is this the collapsing bridge section? I need to be careful with this bird. Oh, no, never mind. No, I already did that, right? Oh, what a gorgeous background. This nice purple twilight sunset. Okay, missed the double. Oh, and here's the other scroller I was saying earlier. So, this might seem really perilous and really urgent, like they're really urging you to progress downward as quick as you can. Don't fall for that shit. Just chill out and don't rush. Let the platforms show up underneath your feet. They do crumble while you're standing on them, and they'll eventually give way. You can make them last longer by just jumping a bit, so you're not spending as much time actually standing on them. Just don't rush through that, and it's really easy. I was kind of hoping that would be wall chicken, but it's just a heart. So this is just like the time that we fought the two mummies in the gargoyle, except now there's a third coffin, so you can see there's gonna be a third boss. This might be one of the more challenging bosses before we actually get to Death and Dracula, simply because there's so many enemies to fight. Then again, because of these upper platforms up here, neither of the first two bosses can actually hit you, if you don't want them to. Like, you can just chill out up there. Mummies have no way of hitting you from up here. The boss coming next, which you can probably guess, is another gargoyle. Wait, gargoyle? No, Cyclops, sorry, Cyclops. I think I said gargoyle earlier, too. The Cyclops can't hit you from up here, just like the very first time you fight him. But then again, it's also kind of hard to hit his eye while standing up there. So when he does his little chugga-chugga-choo-choo, getting ready to charge animation, start running so you can make it over him, because he's getting ready to charge you, and he does run much faster than you do. Gosh, I got hit. Well, might as well take advantage of the invincibility and just finish him. I don't think the third and final boss here has any real chance of killing me, so that's fine. God damn, look at that. Look at that red armor looking thing. It's fucking Baphomet. Satan. Pazuzu. Am I only saying Pazuzu because I'm thinking... Yeah, I'm only saying it because I'm thinking Futurama, the gargoyle. The professor's gargoyle is named Pazuzu. Pazuzu is like some sort of, Hebrew demon, right? Or is it just like Abrahamic religions in general? Not sure. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, everyone. We made it to the castle proper. We're gonna pick up next time on a new save file going down Alucard's path. Thanks for watching. Take it easy. Have a good one.